so much sorrow here, so much shame and hurt and fear. And there's grief, feels like the ache, it's never ending. The night is long, can't find sleep. Don't have the words to pray, there's no comfort, no joy today. Where is love we long to see, a new beginning? The night is long, can't find sleep. Where has peace gone? Fierce dreams like Mary did, brave dreams like Joseph did, new dreams like Jesus did, 'cause those who dream change everything, those who dream change everything. In the dark, oh, dreams start in the dark. So don't give up, don't give up. It's time to dream fierce dreams like Mary did, brave dreams like Joseph did. Jesus did, 'cause those who dream change everything, those who dream change everything, change everything.
Good morning and welcome to worship this morning. Thank you for joining us at Asbury United Methodist Church. I am Pastor Erica Gravely, and we are worshiping live together this morning. Us here, the crew here behind the scenes are worshiping together along with you in your home, wherever you are. We are glad that you joined us this morning. So we are live this morning, so all the fun things in happening with that, but a way to get us all together, to feel connected as we are worshiping together. And if you could let us know that you're here this morning, you can fill out the connection card that our host B will put up for you. Let us know you're here, let us know who's worshiping with you this morning. Also, if you are new to Asbury through the internet, we'd love for you to fill out a connection card too, that we can learn more about you and what you're interested in and get you connected into the life here at Asbury. But I hope if you are a visitor or you're a regular attender that you feel God's presence as we come together and worship this morning. This is the first Sunday in Advent. We are celebrating the time of a new season where we are preparing for Jesus to come into our world. It's a time of looking within, with broadening our relationship with our God who cares so deeply for us, who hears our our concerns, our worries, our fears, and how we need a Savior in this world. So we are beginning a new series this Advent season called Those Who Dream. So I hope you join us as we go on this journey of dreams and the dreams of God and the people in Scripture of what could be. So one way that we can get you connected here in worship, if you have any prayer concerns at all, you can post them in the comment section on Asbury Live, or if you want to post it anonymously, you can go to our website and click the link there and post your concerns there, and we can lift them up during worship or with the prayer team during the week. And some ways we're building in the community, for the month of November, we are collecting for Methodist Manor, and this is the last week that we're collecting for that, so if you're able to bring in items, we're looking for warm clothing, stocking caps and gloves, throw blankets, hygiene products, stationery, postcards and stamps, or stuffed animals, other fun things for the residents at Methodist Manor. So I hope you can contribute to that. And let's see, oh yes, because we are beginning the season of Advent, we are finding ways for us to get together to sing, and so we are having a Christmas carol sing called Heaven and Nature Sing. It's going to be outside in the parking lot, and it may be warm, it may be cold, but we hope you can join us at 3 p.m. next Sunday and dress accordingly, and but the warmth of the spirit of our song will keep us warm together, and just a way to get together to sing the old traditional carols and songs. I hope you can join us. We'll have one on December 6th and also December 20th. So I hope you can join us. And then also, I mailed these out earlier in the month, the commitment cards for next year. I spoke about it in worship last week, so I hope you could get a hold of that and fill this out in the ways that you can commit for next year. It's helpful for us in our planning for ways that we can do ministry in the following year. But also as just a commitment to put pen to paper as a way to commit to what you plan on giving back to God in the next year. So you can either fill out this card that was mailed to you, or if you didn't receive one, you can go online and Bea's gonna put up a link there that you can fill it out, and it will be mailed to our office, or sent to our office. And then, of course, wanna say a special happy birthday to those celebrating this week for John Fuge, Leon Johnson, Dana Cullum, Raylan Patterson, and Lincoln Johnson. So may the love that you give to others all year round come back to you on your special day. Happy birthday. Hear this poem written for this series. As we come into worship, as we come into this series, hear these words. It takes strength to dream. I imagine it's the same strength that leads people to say, I love you, first. Those three vulnerable words, wrapped in heartstrings, whispered, because what could be is too good to keep quiet about. It takes strength to choose joy. It takes strength to push the covers off our weary bodies, morning after morning, to plant weary feet on solid ground, and to look for signs of beauty. It takes strength to remember that we are not alone, but the story starts with bone of bone and flesh of flesh. That feels like so long ago. Oh yes, it takes strength to dream. I imagine that's why many choose not to, for it would be far easier to simply sleep. But there are always those who dream, those who are who are up at night picturing what could be, because this world is too good not to. So we say, I love you. We push the covers off. We find solid ground. We look for beauty, and we dream. We dare to dream.
I dream of sunflower fields.
I dream of key lime pie with a mile-high meringue.
I dream of the days when we could be part of a crowd.
I dream of snow days.
I dream of empty beds in jail cells.
I dream of a world that will let kids be kids.
I dream of full tables instead of empty bellies.
I dream of schools with enough money to teach.
I dream of parents with enough money to feed.
I dream to keep awake, because if we don't dream of better days, then we might forget that this is not what God imagined.
So today we light the candle of hope, for hope is the very thing that keeps dreams afloat.
May this light be an invitation to keep awake.
May this light be our invitation to be Advent people, people who dream. Amen.
Please join responsibly in the call to worship. The power of dreams lies in waking up, for when we close our eyes,
we can see a better world.
When we close our eyes,
we can dream a better dream.
But when we open our eyes,
we begin the work of faith.
The power of worship is the same. When we enter this space,
we can see a better world.
When we enter this space,
we dream a better dream.
But when we leave this space,
we begin the work of faith.
So come in, dream your dream.
Find hope here.
For in an hour,
we will begin the work of faith.
Let it be so.
O God of great dreams, you dreamed up the stars in the sky. You dreamed up that magic baby smell and the way cream sinks into coffee. You dreamed up the crunch of fall leaves and jazz music. You dreamed up wisteria and evergreen and the pure magic that is a 6-foot-long sunflower. And in the midst of all of that, you dreamed up a dream for your people, a dream of hope and justice, a dream for eyes wide open to both the world's suffering and the world's beauty. So today, as we read scripture, we ask that you would plant that same dream in us. Pour out your spirit on our hearts and minds, so that we may see what you see, dream what you dream. Gratefully we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
Gospel of Mark, Jesus shares with his friend his dream of the future and what we must do to prepare for it.
Mark 13:24-37. But in those days after that suffering, the sun will be darkened, and the moon will not give its light, and the stars will be falling from heaven, and the powers in the heavens will be shaken. Then they will see the Son of Man coming in the clouds with great power and glory. Then he will send out the angels and gather his elect from the four winds, from the ends of the earth to the ends of the heaven. From the fig tree, learn its lesson. As soon as its branch becomes tender and puts forth its leaves, you know that summer is near. So also, when you see these things taking place, you know that he is near, at the very gates. Truly I tell you, this generation will not pass away until all these things have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. But about that day or hour, no one knows, neither the angels in heaven nor the Son, but only the Father. Beware, keep alert, for you do not know when the time will come. It is like a man going on a journey when he leaves home and puts his slaves in charge, each with his work, and commands the doorkeeper to be out on watch. Therefore, keep awake, for you do not know when the master of the house will come in the evening or at midnight or at the cockcrow or at dawn. Or else he may find you asleep when he comes suddenly. And what I say to you, I say to all, keep awake.
Do you remember the dream that you had last night? Do you hold it in your mind like an odd puzzle, trying to decipher why such an odd series of events would travel through your mind? Why were you flying or running or having a conversation with a monkey? Was it comforting, concerning, or downright mystifying? Dreams have a way of bending the rules of time and space and reality. There really are no rules. Anything can happen when you shut your eyes, and we submit to that every night. And when we wake up for the day, the trance is over and reality sets in, hitting us so hard that many of us grab that cup of coffee really quickly. We've faced many harsh realities this year, and we would all like to wake up from this nightmare. For some, COVID is the only nightmare. For others, the nightmare has lasted much longer than just this year and has only worsened with the current pandemic. We take the dream of our sleep and will it into the reality of our lives as a way to see past the frustration, the dead ends, the injustice, to a place where things can be exactly the way we want them to be. As we dream, the anxieties of the world loosen their grip on our soul, and we're able to think of scenarios outside of normal existence. Unlike a dream in our sleep, we can control the characters, the situations, and the outcome. Dreaming is like a canvas where we place whatever or whomever we want in it. That is why you will experience so many forms of art in this series, Those Who Dream. Art of word, song, and image fill this series as artists capture their dreams in order for us to see their hope beyond the current situation. In the Gospel of Mark, we hear Jesus' dream for the future of God's people. Some name this passage the Little Apocalypse. Apocalypse meaning revelation, a small revealing of what the future holds for us. He tells his friends of a future using familiar words spoken by the prophets Isaiah and Daniel. The sun will be darkened, and the moon will not give its light, and the stars will be falling from the heaven, and the powers in the heavens will be shaken. God's might will be at hand. And we want to crack the code so desperately to know when the day of reckoning is here so we can sit in our holy stadium seats and watch the heathens not like us suffering below. It always feels so good when the bad people in your life get their just desserts. But Jesus adds his own dream on top of the prophets as he tries to explain it to his friends. You know the fig trees, he says, growing around the city or in your backyard? How you see the flower and the bud and the fruit turning from green to brown, and you pluck it and you eat this delicious fruit that nourishes you? That is how you know the time is near. Not natural catastrophes of flood, fire, or locusts that bring us death and destruction, but as something that brings forth life, nourishment, and sustenance. And it is sweet and pleasing. It's a blessing. But, he warns, do not be asleep. Keep alert, he keeps on saying. You do not want to miss this blessing. The realities of life are fast and furious. But meanwhile, in the background, the leaves of the fig tree are soaking up the sun, blooming, growing and producing good fruit. Jesus is dreaming so much that he is awake. Awake to the issues going on at the time. The way God's people are being mistreated by the Roman Empire. The way God's beloved are taken advantage of by religious leaders. The way people are losing hope because the odds are stacked against them. Mark writes this gospel message to a reader who is looking for hope beyond despair, a follower who has discovered the way with Jesus, yet is meeting a hardship on this new journey. These days, we would call Jesus so awake to the issues, people would call him woke, a slang word of admiration and respect for someone who is very aware of the issues going on in the world, how injustices have been happening, and knows what to do about it. The creation team here at Asbury, you could say, is woke. Woke to the issues concerning the well-being of our planet and are trying to implement ways for us to leave a lighter footprint. The knitting group here is woke. Woke to the foster children who are in need of items after they are taken from dire living conditions and placed into safe places. And the group crafts blankets and other items for ambassadors for children. In the devotional booklet from our Advent in the Bag, we have early on a comment, a perspective written by Dr. Marcia Riggs, who is the professor of Christian ethics at Columbia Theological Seminary. And she writes on Mark 13, and says, to be people of God requires an ethical posture of attentiveness, to keep awake. To be people of God, we must be attentive, attentive as the Good Samaritan was attentive to the bruised and battered person on the side of the road, while others were not and walked right on by. Keeping awake to the person sitting a distance from the healing waters of the pool of Bethesda while others stepped over him. Woke to the foreign woman who has no right to ask for the crumbs on the floor because others say they were only meant for God's chosen people. How awake are we? How woke are we? Are the concerns of the day just passing us by? Do the issues of injustice skim over the surface of our awareness like a smooth, flat rock that taps us just a little bit and keeps on going? Being awake to the realities of what is going on in our world, that we start Advent in a world of pandemic and protest. In a world where we have easily slipped into our own little bubbles, and those on the outside are merely human objects, not of our concern. Are our self-serving dreams the ones that really make a difference and give hope for all in the future? Friends, God has dreams. Dreams that when the world was created, that we would be living with God, in harmony with God and each other. Even when we stepped out of Eden, God held on to the dream that we would one day be in that place again. Heaven coming to earth, God dwelling with us. And in these right relationships, the world will be repaired and something new will be created. What do we dream of that is on the other side of this pandemic, the protests or the troubles in our world? If you are for protests or not, I have a feeling that the desired outcome is still the same. If you believe in the dangers of the pandemic or not, I have a feeling that we are all dreaming of the same outcome. What are we truly dreaming and hoping for? African-American poet Langston Hughes, who happens to have been born in Joplin, Missouri, wrote several poems on dreams, attempting to look past his current fight of segregation in America at the time, to dream of a time and place where such prejudice would be gone. Hear Langston Hughes' dreams in I Dream a World. I dream a world where man no other man will scorn, where love will bless the earth and peace its paths adorn. I will dream a world where all will know sweet freedom's way, where greed no longer saps the soul, nor avarice blights our day. A world I dream where black or white, whatever race you be, will share the bounties of the earth and every man is free. Where wretchedness will hang its head and joy, like a pearl, attends the needs of all mankind. Oh, of such a dream, such I dream, my world. Hughes is awake to the difficulties and injustices in the world around him, yet dreams of a better future filled with hope. With the hope of a fig ripening on a tree that offers life, nourishment, and well-being. A hope with fresh possibilities for deliverance and human wholeness, where all can be all. Amen. And now we come to a time of prayer in response to these words. If you have any prayer requests or joys or concerns, I'll give you this time now to share it with the community online.
So far, there are no specific prayer requests in the chat, but we'll add Teresa Kays to our list. She is not here this morning playing for us. And then prayers for those that are on the screen.
Okay. Thank you, Bob. Let us turn the concerns and joys in our hearts to God. Let us pray. Original dreamer, over and over again in Scripture, we hear your dream for a beautiful world. We hear your dream for peace and reconciliation. We hear your dream for harmony and togetherness. We hear your dream for community and hope. We hear your dreams, and yet we do not open our eyes. We continue to live with the curtains drawn, the covers pulled tight, eyes shut to the realities of the world. Forgive us. Kindle a hope in us that will burn through the darkest nights. Give us the strength and the will to keep awake in this sleeping world. Keep us awake to the things that keep you awake. We hold our hearts and pray for Teresa and the family, for Marjorie Roper, and for so many affected by COVID. For the loved ones of those who have died, comfort them. For those who are battling a diagnosis, place your healing hand upon them. For those who watch from the distant sideline as loved ones fight, offer them assurance that you can go where they cannot. For essential healthcare workers who are constantly trying to adapt to new things this disease brings, give them wisdom. We all dream of a time when this will dissolve and only live in our memory. We dream when hugs are given in abundance, great groups gather together to sing praises to you, when we can break bread together as a sign of remembering and healing. We pray for the many problems that have existed long before COVID, the age-old problems and isms that objectify and diminish. Help us to dream big dreams that see beyond this pain. Help us to see the life you wish all of us to live in, all of us. We thank you for the hopes realized and the joy in life that you bring. We pray for your Holy Spirit to lift our spirits, encourage us to live into your dreams, where the bounties of this earth are shared with one another and all are free, where wretchedness will hang its head and joy like a pearl attends the needs of all. With hope, we pray these things in Jesus' name, who taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the glory, and the power forever and ever. Amen. And so, we have the gifts from those who have given throughout the week. Remember, there are many ways that you can return your gifts to God, through mail or through online, or we can pick it up for you. But also, remember to fill out your commitment card and make that commitment for the future of God's ministry, that we can fulfill the dreams that God has for us. Let us turn to God in song for the doxology.
See a star shine, and its splendor fills up the sky. It's the same that appeared and the wise men revered when hope was born this night out upon. echoes the grace of our Savior's embrace, because hope was born this night. Glory to God in the highest, peace on earth, goodwill toward men. Let all of the world sing a chorus of joy, because hope was born this night. I can hear the Christmas bells ring as softly a church choir sings. It's the song used to praise the Ancient of Days when hope was born this night. There are angels in this place, and my heart resounds with the praise. Like a shepherd so scared, I'll rejoice and declare that hope was born this night. Glory to God in the highest, peace on earth, goodwill toward men. Let all of the world sing a chorus of joy, because hope was born this night.
So friends, as you go, may you have the strength to dream with wild dreams of hope, peace and joy that overflows. May you have the humanity to listen to the dreams of others. May you have the confidence to trust that the God who heard the cries of the Israelites in Egypt hears your dreams as well. And may you have the conviction to return to this space. For our best dreams are those we dream together. In the name of God, the original dreamer, Jesus, the dream come true, and the Holy Spirit who enables us to be those who dream. Go in peace and go in love. Amen. And we will close, as in spirit of Thanksgiving weekend, we will close with this video compiled of all that Asbury has done in this past year. We thank you for all the ministry you have done through Asbury. Peace be with you.
What a wondrous time.